happening here. The pumpkins are out in full force, and the Roger Williams Park Zoo has been welcoming families in celebration of the Jack-o'-lantern spectacular. More than 5,000 carved pumpkins are on display right now, and our own Brendan Kirby is there live getting an inside look at this amazing show that people of all ages can enjoy. Isn't that right, Brendan?
That's right, Michaela. Even big kids like myself absolutely love the Jack-o'-lantern spectacular. We are here, as you said, getting an inside scoop as to what's going on here. It's just, for lack of a better word, spectacular. And I am joined right now by the founder and creator of this great event, John Reckner. John, good morning, sir.
Yeah, good morning, Brendan.
Always great to talk to you. You know, you, sir, we were chatting about this, are the founder and creator, like I just said, of this terrific event. And talk to me about where you drew inspiration for this event 27 long years ago.
28 years ago, Brendan, went to northern Vermont, saw a mountainside display of simple jack-o'-lanterns, and returning home to Oxford, Mass, fast forward, took my dogs for a walk through the woods one evening, and a light bulb goes off. Giant pumpkins in a wooded setting, illuminated artwork and music, and that's where we are today.
And it is an absolutely beautiful display. I saw it just the other night, and every year you guys, you just build and build and build, you know. You change the theme up, and this year's theme is Jack-o'-lanterns A to Z, correct?
Correct. We start off with Alice in Wonderland for A, Birds and the Bees, and right now we're in front of the Christmas skit. Mm-hmm. This is the Norman Rockwell Saturday Evening Post covers.
Right.
And then we move on, dinosaurs, all the way up to letter Z for Roger Williams Zoo.
It's great. There's definitely something for everyone. And I'm told several of the volunteers actually live in this house back here.
Oh, we hide them away.
But there really is, as we said, something for everyone. This is the quintessential fall event. Families can come out. Like Michaela said when she introduced me here today, people of all ages. It's a fun way to get in the spirit of Halloween and just to have fun with fall, isn't it?
Well, that's it. We try to be family-oriented and have something for kids from 3 up to age 90.
And talk about how you're able to maintain this and talk, you know, about the electricity, how at night they all become illuminated and how it's all kind of connected.
Well, interesting enough, we use fluorescent bulbs to illuminate these. And even with the fluorescent bulbs, Brendan, they heat the pumpkin up to about 130 degrees, so it's a constant battle. Every week we have to change every pumpkin in this show.
And it's a great team that you have here. We're going to learn more about them in a little bit, but they are maintaining and keeping this thing going day after day, hour after hour, aren't they?
Oh, it's nonstop. We have a small army of people just do the background pumpkins, and we have roughly a dozen and a half artists that are 7 days a week, 10 in the morning to midnight.
Awesome. Well, John, congratulations on another great jack-o'-lantern spectacular.
Thank you.
This is the guy, John Reckner. He founded and created this great event. He thought of the idea 28 years ago, but it's now in its 27th year. Jack-o'-lanterns A to Z is the theme this year. You don't want to miss this great event. A little later, as I said, we're going to have a sneak peek, a little behind-the-scenes look at how they maintain this great show day after day. It's the Roger Williams Zoo Jack-o'-lantern Spectacular. Back to you.
Welcome back to the Road Show. As we head into the long Columbus Day weekend, many families will be looking to enjoy some fall fun right here in New England. And one of the most popular events to check out at this time of year is the Jack-o'-lantern Spectacular at the Roger Williams Park Zoo. It's a long-standing tradition that draws crowds all month long. Brendan Kirby is there live this morning learning all about this family-friendly attraction. Brendan, what are you up to now?
Hey, Michaela, we're getting the behind-the-scenes tour of this great event, and just a couple days ago, I got the inside scoop and met the team that keeps this tremendous event flowing day after day.
For 27 years, the Roger Williams Park Zoo's Jack-o'-lantern Spectacular has been delighting visitors each fall.
Spectacular tradition for all of Rhode Island, for all of New England. People have come here, you know, year after year, and this year is just as good, if not better than ever.
Not only is it a fun family event, but when you attend, you're helping the zoo as well. It's their biggest fundraiser.
We really rely on people coming out, enjoying the show and supporting the zoo. And all those proceeds go towards our animal care, our conservation programs, our education programs. So you're really doing a great thing by coming out.
They're open daily now through November 2nd. Ticket sales start at 6 p.m. and the trail opens at dusk. But be on the lookout for updates.
We are open rain or shine. If the weather does get too severe, we might have to close the trail down if it's a threat to people. But check our website if you're not sure, and check our social media to get the latest updates on the show.
There's something for everyone, and this year's theme is Jack-O-Lanterns A to Z. We met the team working to keep it all looking and flowing so spectacularly.
Oh, these guys are unbelievable. Opening night, we have 100-some pumpkins to go out. We got 20 minutes before showtime. We got people scrambling, gutting, carving, running them out. But it's like that every year.
It's an extremely involved process, from general maintenance and pumpkin replacing to creating and placing the new carvings.
The actual intricate pumpkins are treated with extra special care. And once they're gutted, of course, they're on a clock. And what we do, we put industrial fans to cure the pumpkins, dry them out really good, and it'll give them an extra 3 or 4 days of shelf life.
As they maintain the show day after day, what happens to all of that extra debris? The Passion for Pumpkins crew put me to work, and I found out firsthand.
I've punched in, I'm ready to go. I'm ready for battle. Am I ready?
Yeah, you're
Let's do it.
Ready to roll.
Let's get dirty.
I got in there with the guys, and they armed me with the tools of the trade.
In the trenches. You don't see Will Gilbert out here doing this, do you?
Off it goes. They haul it away and turn the excess shavings and carvings into compost to benefit the environment.
Last year was a terrific season. We had 130,000 people here. And that was a record for us. And it does a lot of good things for the zoo. And I think that's what gives me a lot of fulfillment.
Gentlemen, thank you very much for having us here today. Whew, I'm not used to this. I usually only work an hour a day. So, you know.
The Roger Williams Park Zoo Jack-O-Lantern Spectacular. It's a show that must be seen to be believed.
Big thanks to all of them for letting us get the inside scoop on how they maintain this great show. For now, back over to you. Hey guys, that's right, we are still here at the tremendous Jack-O-Lantern Spectacular. Roger Williams Park Zoo is the place, and right now I am joined by Lou Perotti. He is the director of the conservation programs here at the zoo. Good morning, Lou.
Good morning, Brendan.
Thank you so much for joining us here today. So much to talk about with you, and we were touching upon this earlier, but the Jack-O-Lantern Spectacular really allows the programs to roll on and to continue to educate people and visitors to the zoo, doesn't it?
Exactly. By coming to visit the Jack-O-Lantern Spectacular, all that money helps and goes to support not only our animal care, but our conservation and education programs.
And there are so many great events that go on here at the zoo. Certainly the Jack-O-Lantern Spectacular is what we're focusing on here today. But talk about some of the other things that people can experience when they come on out.
Oh, one exciting event we'll be having the last week of the month on the 25th and 26th, our Spooky Zoo event. You can come, there'll be all kinds of Halloween events. You can see more crazy critters like this creepy little hissing cockroach I have here. It's a Madagascan hissing roach. All kinds of fun things. Kids, if they come in costume, can get in for half price if they're under 12.
All right.
12 and under. But all the events are free with the zoo admission. So it's a great program to bring the whole family down for.
Absolutely. And what do we really need to know about this guy? You said he's from where again? Originally indigenous to what part of the world?
He's from Madagascar. He's a hissing cockroaches. A lot of people don't realize there's 4,500 species of roaches in the world.
Right.
Only 30 of which are pets.
Wow.
Most of them actually very valuable to the ecosystem as recyclers, and you know, they eat up all that dead fruit and things that fall to the ground.
So they do serve a purpose, really.
A very big purpose, yeah. They're very important in the ecosystem as recycling type critters. So they're fun, but often misunderstood as creepy and crawly. But you'll be able to see creatures like this guy, spiders, scorpions, snakes, all kinds of fun things and animal encounters going on through our Spooky Zoo event.
And that's what the kids love. You know, what I really love about it is the young people who may be interested in animals, maybe becoming veterinarians, they can come, they can really learn about these animals up close and personal, can't they?
Absolutely, absolutely. And that's what we hope will spark the next generation of conservationists and, you know, the folks that are going to take care of our planet in the future. So that's one of our goals.
Sure. And how rewarding is it for you, you know, as the director of the conservation programs, to see that happening year after year, to see the zoo continuing to grow? I imagine you have a lot of pride in that, I would imagine.
I certainly do. And, you know, for every child we touch, touch, you know, we touch 10 more. And, you know, yes, to me that's gratifying because someday I'm going to get old and not be able to do this anymore. And, you know, it's these kids that, you know, we're helping to inspire that are going to be the ones that are going to be the keepers of our planet someday. So.
Tremendous. Well, Lou, thank you very much. You want to put that guy on my jacket? Are we going to do that? He's going to crawl up my jacket. Is what he's going to do, you guys. I'm getting a little bit nervous, but that's it. It's the Roger Williams Park Zoo Jack-O-Lantern Spectacular. It's happening now through November 2nd. Ticket sales open at 6 p.m. daily, and it starts at dusk. You guys do not want to miss this. It's a tremendous event.